Elizabeth II. During this period of mourning, our celebrations may be slightly more muted than usual, but that does not make your achievements any less significant. Before official proceedings begin today, we as a Royal College would like to mark this moment by paying tribute to our Queen, who died last week. I know our trainees, fellows, members, council officers, and staff of the RCOG all join the many millions of people across the globe in paying tribute to a much loved and respected man, a figure known for her profound sense of duty and devotion to her country and to the Commonwealth. Her loss will be felt greatly, and her service remembered fondly. As a Royal College with 16,000 members, many from Commonwealth countries, we are proud of our connection to the Royal Family and the support it brings. The Queen opened our college building in Sussex Place in July 1960. We are recipients of an impressive Terence Cunier painting, which commemorates that moment, and it remains a treasured possession. You may see it hanging on this floor, just outside the hall. You may see it hanging on this floor, just outside this hall. It depicts the Queen in the old Nuffield Hall, surrounded by members of the college, resplendent in their finery. But the other star of the picture is undoubtedly a small girl, no more than 4 years old, attending the event with her mother. Well, in 2010, we managed to track this little girl down, Amber. She was in her mid-50s at the time we tracked her down and living in the Bahamas. And she told us that having completed her curtsy and having given the Queen a bouquet of flowers, she proceeded to whisper to the Queen, much to the horror of everyone present, that if she walked backwards down the stairs, as formality had instructed her to do, she would fall over, and could she please turn around? To which, of course, Her Majesty answered yes. This was just one occasion when we welcomed Her Majesty to our college, but there were so many others, as captured so wonderfully in this short tribute. Guiding is the most amazing specialty. We've the privilege of supporting and caring for women throughout their entire lives, and the sheer breadth of this life course approach means we can choose the areas that interest us most. The college is here to help you find that focus and make your career as fulfilling as it can be, and I hope that you will make the most of the vast opportunities to learn and develop that come from being a member of that lifelong community ONG professionals around the world. And this is a truly global college, shown by the sheer number of different countries here today. And I strongly believe that it's only by learning and working together that we are able to make a real difference to oneself. You are the future of our profession, and I hope you will feel inspired to get involved with the college over the coming months and years to help us continue in our mission to improve the health of women and girls across the world. Congratulations again. Welcome to your college, and have a lovely day. So we now begin with the admission of our honorary fellows. I'd like now to call upon Dr. Ronnie Thacker, RCOG Senior Vice President, but very importantly, President-elect, to introduce Dr. Tuja Josie Kumar Kaur, Fellowship Honours.
Anja Mitra. Leticia Basi.
So that concludes the formal proceedings for today's ceremony. I do hope that you will join the officers, council and myself for refreshments in the foyer just outside. Thank you once again. Many, many congratulations.